Doesn't matter.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. It's time for match number three. And you're probably sitting there going, well, what S&D? Because that was stupidly fast. Just quick shout out to the sponsors, DXR Racer. Is it DX Racer?
I keep saying DXR Racer.
DX Racer. If you guys want to get yourself one of these, you can do. They are fantastic. The players love them. The casters love them. They're just great.
They are fantastic chairs, yeah. Of course. Also, a fantastic match. Well, unless you, if you want competitive matches, not so much. If you want to watch his brutalization beatdowns, then this is the match for you.
Oh, yeah.
Denial looked fantastic in that search and destroy. Of course,
the hard point was close.
Yeah, the hard point was good within 8 points, and I expect the respawn game modes to kind of go back to something similar to that. Of course, I can actually just start the match. I always forget to do that because I'm so focused on how awesome the match is going to be.
But of course, dedicated host hope.
Yeah, without a doubt. But of course, again, you know, the hard point within 8 points, and that was with Saints going 21-30. So not a great performance, you know, out of him at all. But you expect if he can turn around, come back up, Link, can it be a completely different Mayboat? And without a doubt, I think Elevate's going to be able to take this.
Okay, well, to be honest with you, I mean, Denial still look completely buzzing from that last game. They just look at how hyped they still are. They're like, wow, you know, everything we tried worked. Every kind of, you know, unorthodox to play that way takes supreme confidence. And it's actually built upon that confidence, winning it 6-0.
Yeah, I just think Elevate is going to be, you know, have the confidence to be able to bounce back from this sort of thing. But Denial has looked fantastic. Also, you know, we are going to see what's going to happen off the bat. Of course, we got to watch Huke off the start. Had the hot hand in the search and destroy. Going to have three players in front of him. Potentially good start for Elevate, shutting Huke down right away.
Now, this is all going to be about glass control. And both squads look like they're just going to kind of stand up from each other and look to get it first of all. But they are now flooding in. Temp looking for another kill. And he's going to see Classic up top. It should be glass control falling in favor of Denial to begin with, if they can just make one more string of kills.
Yeah, and you can see Temp, you know, 3-0 right now. He's going to have the drone as well. Somehow able to survive that and all four down in their favor. This is a quick start for Denial. They're going to be able to get 2 points on the board without a doubt. And now they're going to be able to get back to that rotation as well, still picking up kills in the spawn of Elevate.
Look at that. Slowly edging back. And they're going to rely on their teammates to pick this one up. It's going to be replaced with the drone straight away. They've made enough kills to at least get a one here, but no. Has been shut down as he goes so far to try and get the two. Hook will now pick it up. He has drone control. He's going to go for the one. Did he get it? No! Interception! TJ Halley. It was this map where he made the interception famous last time I cast him at USG. But now he will have the control of the drone. Goes down by Green.
And Saints going to be the last one up for his team. Is able to pick up one kill, but is just going to have too many players to deal with. And you can see Denial already pushing up. They're not going to go for that rotation over. They're going to be pushing straight through. Again, the aggression out of them. And you can see Slasher able to hit the one-point toss, of course. Elevate able to clear out their base, at least for the most part. But still, the damage has been done. Denial with a 3-0 lead.
Well, it looks like they are now set up for it. They needed to try and get that kill down as well to secure Yellow. Now, Classic, can he use the movement in the right way to get this in? And he has. Perfect play there to get into top Yellow.
You know, this is actually something I haven't, you know, thought about until, you know, just a moment ago. I haven't seen Elevate when they're working from behind. I'm used to seeing them on top. Again, they've had a fantastic tournament so far, but I'm not sure how they are going to be able to bounce back. Of course, now you can see TJ on a 5-streak. Of course, the dunk comes in, and now it's just a 3-3 game. So maybe they're going to be perfectly capable of that, but just something to consider moving forward.
Well, let's jump on board with Slasher now. And it is all tied up here, but I mean, we've actually seen teams this weekend win from both sides. And if I remember correctly, the Face Justice game actually ended up being the first time round, both sides actually did better from what is usually called the worst side on this map.
Yeah, it does get kind of weird, especially after the spawn change like 2 or 3 months ago. It was kind of a slow transgression over towards this, of course. Now, tie game is what we're seeing so far. Of course, Denial, again, able to outslay their opponent just by a small margin. But again, Saints is still the player I'm looking at, of course. You know, relatively even game right now at 5-7. But again, if he can perform, I think it's going to be, you know, absolutely huge for Elevate. But now you can see Denial, again, putting all the pressure on Elevate. You know, this is at least a 1-point toss, and that is exactly what Temp is going to go for. You know, Slack picked up too, but again, the damage has been done a second time. Denial, 4-3 lead.
I mean, they were looking at, I can see what they were going for, but holding Yellow in the way they did may not have been as good. They didn't really have the bodies for him. He was clearly looking for someone to cut through. Nobody actually did, leaving Hook alone to try and take on 2-3 players that were coming at him. If maybe you backed him up, they would have got a more efficient trade, buying time for their drone carrier to actually get through for a dunk, but 1 point's good enough.
Yeah, and now you can see Denial trying to stack more on the board. Replays has a few players with him, a player going through mid-map as well. That's going to be huge. Cube's able to pick up one. That's at least going to distract the opponent. Elevate had two in their base, but you see Saints in the kill feed. Had to pick up Huke first, and then he wasn't able to turn to replays in time. So another dunk comes in. Denial 6-3 now.
It's one of these situations, especially on this map, because of the way it's set up, that you have to bear in mind that armor and the exo movement is so effective at getting through to actually score these points that you don't have to completely clear the way. You just have to make it dangerous enough for the enemy team to not concentrate on either you or just the drone carrier.
Yeah, and what a fantastic play call out of denial as well. You saw Elvig was pushing in the base. They gave up the points and TJ didn't know it, so he hit the 1 point toss. Meanwhile, all four players going all the way around, overextending across the entire map to get that drone control, and obviously that paid off greatly for them. Now they're back with that drone in hand. You potentially setting up for a 1 point stop, but you see TJ able to stop it, able to hit that reset.
Yeah, just not able to get out of there in time. And this is what I said, I mean, if you get enough bodies in there, like they do, I mean, Slack now going down means that Temp will play this. And I'll tell you, that's sometimes dangerous to throw out there because you can't hit the motorway and come back.
Yeah, I thought he was going to do that, but of course, landed in the exact same position anyway if that were the case. But still, 30 seconds left again. And both teams just trying to get those final points on the board before they move into the second half. And Denial, of course, would love to be able to do that. But Elevate, you can see they're playing passively, have people just stationary in glass. That's going to be Slack. If Elevate can get maybe one or two more kills, they're going to be a good position. Of course, they got to get through Temp. That is going to be the case. He gets straight. TJ Hallett picks up a kill. Going to try and make a run, but Replay is there for the stop.
Yeah, this is just all about control here. Surely they're not going to get this. Saints will now have drone control. Should be okay to get a one. Could actually get the two here. I think he had enough time. But easy one for him. Just so confident he just completely turned away. There was no way in his mind he was missing that.
Yeah, and it's kind of a double-edged sword situation. Again, we saw earlier on where they just took the guaranteed points with a one-point toss when potentially they would have been able to get a two. So maybe that's something we look back at the end of the match and say, man, if they had just, you know, did one thing different, they would have come away with the victory. But at the same time, they're getting points on the board. It's kind of hard to take away from them. And, you know, able to get that deficit within a one-point game going into the quote-unquote better side.
You know, I'm actually quite impressed by Elevate there to kind of rally like they did. We thought it was going to be a little bit one-sided for a little while, but they managed to get 5 points onto the board here, and slaying's more or less even across the entire length and breadth of it. But here we go. It's time to fight for glass and drone control from both squads on board with Classic.
Yeah, and you can see he's trying to play that defensive role. Meanwhile, those Saints has almost no players in front of him as well, and he's going to be able to connect with the one-point toss. That is a 19-second score coming out of Elevate on this second side, tying it up absolutely straight away. That potentially is going to be a huge game changer.
Well, Saints still alive here in this. He's now on a four-streak chance. And it's all about glass control. He is going to be pushed by several players here. Surely he's going to go down in the scenario. He does eventually drop. TJ Halley will now be looking. He's going to see one player. A second player challenges him. It's Slasher who takes him down. Hook will now get it at the same time. And there is a lot of work to do here, realistically, for Denial. They're not in the best of situations where they would want to be at this point in the game.
Of course, you see they have Slasher trying to get that glass control, and that is the player you want, as he is at 21 and 17. But of course, he is going to fall. Slack is going to be able to pick up one. Saints is there as well, but TJ Halley with the drone is going to get stopped, and now Huke able to pick up the two. Slack, though, might be able to get a 1 point toss towards the end. The interception not quite there. That is going to be a 7-6 lead for Team Elevate.
Oh, here we go. They're already resetting once again. This is what I said. Elevate are in a better position. Realistically, they should be able to put more points on the board this side than Denial, and so far it's going that way. But we do know that if you can lock this down and lock down yellow, you can hit the relay.
Yeah, without a doubt. And you can see Denial trying to set up for it. They have two players pushed up in the air before Replay's even got there. Replay's just going to go for the 1 point toss. And Classic, of course, going to be there. And he's tossing it out into the base, of course. No one from Elevate is there. And now it actually might be a chance for Denial to counter. That's a 2 point play. And that is a huge mistake. Instead of hitting the reset, threw it into the hands of exactly where Denial was going to be spawning it. Huke spawned up, said thank you. Didn't even have to get a single kill on the map. Just ran that straight in. And that's Denial taking the lead, of course. Now they are going to be making moves. That is Team Elevate. They have the base clear. Cut out, and of course, they are going to be able to counter right back with a 2 point play of their own.
There's so much of what just happened that actually blew my mind. For a start, taking that 1 point play, you know that was going to be in the center. They called it as soon as he threw out, so there's no way that's going in. Obviously, Classic kind of not throwing that out also blew my mind at the same time. I was like, what? Why would. No, that was just not a good idea. You know you didn't have full control of the area. You had two teammates in front of you around yellow. There seems to be one teammate that could possibly kind of challenge for it. Obviously, the entire team went down. They lost 2 points.
Yeah, and can we talk about how huge TJ Halley just went for his team? There was three players in the mile trying to get that relay score you talked about earlier. Had yellow control. He was able to pick up two, and now it's going to be Saints making moves with that drone. Going to just run straight past two players, splits the defenders, and retakes the lead. This is just dunk after dunk after dunk. I think we've seen 8 or 9 points scored this round. Ridiculously quick stuff as well, but again, Elevate just trying to hold on to that lead as desperately as they can, and now making moves once again. Slack with that drone in hand.
should be able to do something here. No, he's almost going to go for it. Does hit the power slide. There are several members of Elevate here. TJ Halley desperately trying to just do it while he's so heavily stunned. Just not got enough bullets in his gun to kill all those players that come towards him, especially with the armor. Looking to wrap green there, replays. Not able to make that one either. Temp's going to try the same thing. Has blockers with him, though, that he is being chased down, and he's going to reset it there. That's a wise move, in my opinion, and Slack takes him down.
It didn't go out, actually. The thing again, you talked about it early, bouncing off the motorway. That's exactly what happened now, and now you see Elevate's going to be trying to take full advantage of that. Of course, you're going to be there for the stop. Slack, though, with the trade. You can see that's four down in their favor. The mistake, not getting the drone reset in time, and took quite a long time to even attempt it, but again, it bounced off that motorway, cost them another 2 points, just these
they
simple mistakes.
May have cost them this.
And again, this may be game as well. Saints going to go for the rally. No one in position to stop. The Nile's going to have to rotate all the way back around. They do have that glass control, but again, they're going to have to set up some ridiculous relay scores to get back in this towards the end. Down by five, three possession game with just a minute left.
Yeah, they're trying to stay alive here and stop them coming back. Hook will now have drone control. Body's flooding in from Elevate. He's going to go for the one. Will it be the interception again?
Classic.
Classic picks it out of the air.
He does it again.
It's so dangerous, but his teammate is actually there this time. And it's TJ Halley for
three.
The easy pick. And in that one goes.
Oh, there you can see the difference.
This is why it's so dangerous to throw a one without control.
Oh, that is a phenomenal example. Of course, last time around, again, there was nobody there on Classic's team, and it just didn't work out. The kills did not go in their favor. But that is an example of what they were trying to accomplish earlier. So, again, you want to talk about reflecting and fixing mistakes. They just did that in the same half. They fixed their own mistakes. So that's fantastic work. And a 17-10 lead. This game is all but over. Elevate, again, looking very strong in uplink. And I just want to point out Saints, 21-25, still negative by a little bit. But again, instead of negative 17, just by a few. And he was doing the objective work for his team as well. Phenomenal performance all the way across the board.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, we're talking about going back to that play because the same thing happened twice, but, you know, this time a little bit better. TJ Halley was in a great position to actually pick it up this time. Didn't have anyone around him. Like I said, it is risky. It didn't work out last time. This time it did, and then that's the risk you take in those scenarios. One ended up with 2 points against them. The other one ended up them getting a dunk.
Yeah, and I didn't pay too much attention to it because it happened so fast, but it might have been a situation where if TJ Halley was already pushed into green.
He probably screamed.
He knows that he's forcing the spawns of his opponent out, so he can say, hey, if you get the interception, we know they're all on glass side, and even if you get the kills, I know they're not going to spawn up near me, and at the very least, I'll be able to hit a quick one-point toss, and you can see as soon as he got that as well, it was three down in their favor. There was going to be no one left alive, but again, at that point, it was kind of, you know, a blowout game anyway, already a five-point difference between the teams, but either way, we saw Elevate go down 2-0. Maybe they're going to fight back.
Well, we'll find out right after this quick commercial break. Don't go anywhere.